Mavericks has some of the biggest waves on Earth.
I haven't told this anyone, so you have to keep it a secret. Mavericks is real.
Mavericks.
Maybe the biggest wave in the world.
When Jay discovers the mythic surf spot, he decides he must conquer it.
I want to ride that wave.
That wave is a myth. And the four of us who surf it intend to keep it that way.
So we enlist local legend Frosty to help him survive it.
This is going to change everything.
In Chasing Mavericks.
Hi, I'm Liz.
I'm Sean.
And we're joined today by JimmyO from JoeBlow.com.
Howdy.
And we're here today to discuss Chasing Mavericks, the new film directed by Michael Apted and Curtis Hanson. We've all just seen it. Sean, why don't you start us off?
Chasing Mavericks is the story of Jay Maroarty, who, under the tutelage of his neighbor Frosty, wants to surf Mavericks, which is this gigantic wave that many people think is a myth, but as it turns out, because it's a movie, it's not a myth, and he wants to surf it. Jay is played by Jonny Weston, and Frosty's played by Gerard Butler, and I thought that that relationship was good. It was, you know, it's kind of cliche in the sense that not only did they learn how to surf, but they also learn things about life. But I think that the story is well told and done well by those two actors.
Between the two leads, there is a slight spark, but not enough to carry the movie. So many of the other characters are wasted. It brings up too many ridiculous subplots that go nowhere, and the wave kind of dies out before it really makes a splash.
Mm.
Sorry, had to do it.
Nice.
Well, the film is about this character, Jay, and his love of surfing.
Hey, sir. Hey, I want to ride that wave. I want to take that drop.
Not going to happen.
Why not?
Because untrained boys don't step in the ring with Mike Tyson, that's why.
Everything in the film, from the script, from the directing, to the cinematography, did well to establish that and to support that throughout. For me, there was a through line, there was a passion, and I don't know much about surfing. It terrifies me. I never want to get in the water. But I watched the movie, and I saw the absolute adoration that these characters have for the sport of surfing.
Take a look at the rocks over there. See what's happening with the current?
He's got nowhere to go.
Nowhere to go, but where?
Back out?
Exactly. Back out. To a waterman? It's a conveyor belt. Watch this.
You mentioned passion, and I actually thought there was a lack of passion. Great sports films, it doesn't matter whether you play it, whether you're involved, you're inspired. You're like, yeah. This movie, I was like, eh. I mean, even the last 15 minutes, as exciting as it gets, mm-hmm. it doesn't really build up well enough. I didn't see a love of surfing in this film.
I'm going to cite a few examples that worked for me. Okay. And I think a lot of them have to do with cinematography and the performance of Jonny Weston. But there's steel in Jonny Weston's eyes. When he talks about surfing, when he talks about the Mavericks, when he talks to Frosty, there's just this intensity behind his eyes that I'm just like, oh, I'm so inspired. There's someone so focused and driven. And in addition to that, they always shoot the surfers in silhouettes on the top of hills or from below. They shoot them in very heroic ways. And that also made me feel like, oh, this is something that the film is trying to lift up. They're exalting this hobby and this sport to something I haven't seen very often.
Maybe it's not so much that there's not a love of surfing for it, but that the filmmakers were so concentrated on, we want to show a character movie that has surfing in it, that the love of surfing got a little lost in the way.
Well, you mentioned Jonny, and I completely disagree.
I thought you don't love Jonny like I do.
He was fine. He's a fine actor, and I'm sure in another role he would be terrific. Mm-hmm. But this, there was no dynamic. The only character that showed a little dynamic was Gerard.
One bump off the face of that wave, and you're hitting the water like concrete at 50 miles an hour. Then you got 1,000 tons of water coming down on top of you. It's knocking you senseless, ripping you apart.
Gerard Butler's a great actor. He's done a lot of good work. But this guy was very vanilla.
That's a fault I give to the writing. I think Jonny Weston inhabits the vanilla aspect of the character just fine.
All of my problems, I would say, with this film have to do with the script. And I think the script didn't want to go with the simple concept. It didn't want to go with the simple drive of a young man who wants to be a fantastic surfer. So it threw in all these subplots that did not work for me, and I don't think it worked for either of you. It's almost as if the script didn't trust its own theme, its own thesis, and it wanted to up the drama.
Yeah, I mean, there's a tragic occurrence that happens about three quarters of the way in the movie that just comes right out of nowhere.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's fine. Tragedy sometimes happens that way. But in a movie, I kind of felt like, well, they're playing with my emotions at this point.
I do honestly believe that this film is very well directed. Wow. And that, I know you disagree. I'm coming at it from a bias, though. I'm like, Michael Apted is my hero. I love Michael Apted. He's in my like top five. I respect him, and I think Curtis Hanson is brilliant as well.
Yeah.
And I know that they wouldn't just give half an effort in this film.
They do some decent work. I think the actors are fine. I think that the surfing sequences, while not maybe the most kinetic and exciting that have ever been filmed,
they're beautiful, though.
The last 15 minutes are beautiful.
I think all of it was beautiful. I think every time you go into the ocean, every surfing sequence, even when they're paddling along the water, I'm watching, I'm thinking, this is gorgeous photography and is directed well, and there's a soul to the image. I think that this film pushes the spirituality of surfing, and I think that the way it's photographed supports that.
Chasing Mavericks is a bland, passionless, uninspired movie of the week. It didn't really inspire me, and I have to say, skip it.
It's a must for surfer fans, but for everyone else, it's just a passing entertainment. You can wait for it at home. Stream it.
Chasing Mavericks is an imperfect film, I'll grant you this, but it's inspiring, and I enjoyed myself. I'm going to say see it.
Well, it looks like our votes add up to 1.5 tickets, which is a stream it for Chasing Mavericks.
Cheers.
Surf's up.
All right, aloha.
Yeah, I can take a beating, but can he surf?
I wouldn't say it was a perfect 10, or should I say perfect hang 10? No, not good.